Right here, we have a simple map. We also have our robot that needs to localize itself. This robot can use GPS, for example. However, in this case, it's not handy. The few meters of accuracy is way too large in this case. The robot will use a laser scan to gather information about its surroundings. The robot measures a few obstacles, which we can detect. Now we will try to match the measurements of the robot with the map. Doing so, we can guess where the robot is. As you see, this seems like a viable position for the robot to be, depending on its measurements. However, in a large map, this process will become very hard. There may also be multiple positions on the map that look the same, and so the measurements are valid for both. To get more certainty of the position, the robot will start to move and take more measurements. Instead of looking through the whole environment, we can estimate a range of positions where the robot is likely to be. This means that we will not guess random positions in the whole map, as you see in this picture. Doing so results in the following. So, because we track how much the robot moves, we can estimate its new position. This refines our search and increases the validity of our solution and results.